Recording in progress.
And I'm going to make an announcement here. I'm the host today because Sal had high blood pressure when he woke up this morning, and he turned it over to me. His computer is on the session, but he does not seem to be in front of it. So I do not have him down as one of the participants. So we're just going to do it the way I usually do it, which is the boss over here to my right goes first because she's the boss. I go last.
I wish you really meant that.
Yeah. And she is Swambo. So the order of participation is Murray, Steve Einbinder, Bob Winkler, Mike Reeves, Bill Pardon, Kathleen Clark, Debbie and Ron, Lonnie Anderson, Bob Gelb without Susan, Bill and Ray, and then me. And I guess that brings us to the first song.
Well, you didn't mention Steven Einbinder.
Yes, he did.
Yes, I did. I mentioned him right after you.
Oh, and yeah. What about Anna and Ray? Did you mention them?
Yep. Yeah.
I must have fallen asleep.
Okay, so we're going to start off. Pat's going to do a song, and I'm going to say something about this. I get really tired of watching Ron play multiple instruments on these things and me only getting a guitar. So today, you get to hear this. It's a ukulele. So if everybody would mute, and if Steve doesn't mute him, there he goes. Now Pat can make an announcement about what we're going to do.
We're going to sing Blue Skies, written by Irving Berlin in 1926. Blue skies smiling at me, nothing but blue skies do I see. Blue birds singing a song, nothing but blue birds all day long. Never saw the sun shining so bright, never saw things going so right. Noticing the days hurrying by, when you're in love, my, how they fly by. Blue days, all of them gone, nothing but blue skies from now on. Skies smiling at me, nothing but blue skies do I see. Blue birds singing a song, nothing but blue birds all day long. Never saw the sun shining so bright, never saw things going so right. Noticing the days hurrying by, when you're in love, my, how they fly by. Grace, all of them gone, nothing but blue skies from now on.
And Murray, you're up.
Hey. All right, let me get my reading glasses, because this copy that I made is very small print. Okay. I'm going to sing a song Bob Dylan. It was made by Bob Dylan, but he didn't write the music for it. Actually, when he recorded it in 1963, it was a song, by the way, with God on our side. But when he recorded it in 1963, he made up his own words to the song, and also gave it the name, because the melody was the same as the song that Dominic Behan, who was the brother of Brendan Behan, he made this song, The Patriot Game, this Irish song about, the IRA and the other Irish patriots and how they were persecuted by the British and all that. Now the melody is the same. However, and he got angry because Bob Dylan used that melody for his song God on Our Side. But he had some nerve protesting publicly about Bob Dylan doing that, because Dominic Behan didn't make up that melody either. It was an old Irish folk tune. But for some reason, it pissed off Dominic Behan. But anyway, so here we go. Oh, my name, it ain't nothing. My age, it means less. The country I come from is called the Midwest. I was taught and brought up there the laws to abide, and that the land that I live in has God on its side. Oh, the history books tell it, they tell it so well. The cavalry's charged and the Indians fell. The cavalry's charged, the Indians died. Oh, the country was young with God on its side. The Spanish-American War had its day, and the Civil War too was soon laid away. And the names of the heroes I was made to memorize, with guns in their hands and God on their side. The First World War, boys, it came and it went. The reason for fighting I never did get, but I learned to accept it with pride. For you don't count the dead when God's on your side. The Second World War came to an end. We forgave the Germans and then we were friends. Though they murdered 6 million in the ovens they fried, the Germans now too have God on their side. I've learned to hate the Russians all through my whole life. If another war comes, it's them we must fight. To hate them and fear them, to run and to hide, and accept it all bravely with God on my side. But now we've got weapons of the chemical dust. If fire them we're forced to, then fire them we must. One push of the button and a shot the world wide. And you never ask questions when God's on your side. Through many a dark hour I've been thinking about this, that Jesus Christ was betrayed by a kiss. But I can't think for you, you'll have to decide whether Judas Iscariot had God on his side. So now as I'm leaving, I'm weary as hell. The confusion I'm feeling, ain't no tongue can tell. The words fill my head and fall to the floor. That if God's on our side, he'll stop the next war. That's it.
Well sung. I'd forgotten how good that was. What a good song.
Okay, while we were listening to Saul, Doreen D'Amico, while we were listening to Murray, Doreen D'Amico showed up and has been placed at the bottom of the list right after Anna Enright. And currently it's Steve Einhorn's turn to serenade us.
Here's a Simon and Garfunkel song. They say that Richard Corey once owned half of his hometown with political connections to spread his wealth around. Born into society, a banker's only child, he had everything a man could want, power, grace, and style. But I work in his factory, and I curse the life I'm living, and I curse my poverty, and I wish that I could be, oh, I wish that I could be, oh, I wish that I could be Richard Corey. The papers print his pictures almost everywhere he goes. Richard Corey at the opera, Richard Corey at a show, and the rumors of the parties and the orgies on his yacht. Oh, he surely must be happy with everything he's got. But I work in his factory, and I curse the life I'm living, and I curse my poverty, and I wish that I could be, oh, I wish that I could be, oh, I wish that I could be Richard Corey. He really gave to charity, he had the common touch, and they were grateful for his patronage, they thanked him very much. So my mind was filled with wonder when the evening headline read, Richard Corey went home last night and put a bullet through his head. But I work in his factory, and I curse the life I'm living, and I curse my poverty, and I wish that I could be, oh, I wish that I could be, oh, I wish that I could be Richard Corey. That's it.
I haven't heard that one in a long time.
All right, Mr. Winkler.
Okay. I'm going to...
You in Arizona yet?
Hello?
Are you in Arizona yet?
No, I was actually there yesterday. Did the 1,200-mile drive down... what day is today? Sunday. Yeah, Friday. Left at 4 in the morning, arrived at midnight, and flew back yesterday. Got in late last night, so I'm pretty tired. But here I am. Anyway, my wife's down there. She's trying to buy a house, so I got a text from the realtor to sign some documents, and I haven't seen it. So that should be fun. I got to talk to her yet before I sign anything. I'd like to know the floor plan and get more than just a few pictures. I love my wife, but she tends to buy stuff. That's the trait of the female. and stuff shows up, cars show up. You know, we were both single for a very long time, 35 years before we got married. It was not our first marriage, so we're used to doing stuff. Anyway, that's just my story. I tried. Just a side story for you songwriters out there. I went on and got this app, ChatGPT. I said, write a song about, because we shipped our horses on Thursday morning. Said, write a song about two horses, Skyboy and KD, K-D, going from Oregon to Arizona. So it did. That's all I said. And with chorus, it was like three verses and a chorus. And it was a pretty good song, you know, but it was them going on their own, going down to Arizona. And well, I looked at it and I thought it would be going in a truck like we sent them, but they went down and they had a good time, and you know, it was trial and error, and there were no chords or anything or music, but you know, you could put it to it. It was scary. I deleted the thing. It was a three-day free trial and $4.99 a week. Humans are going to be replaced, but not for me. I'll write my own dang song. So anyway, I'll be in and out. I got a couple minutes at a time. I'm doing laundry and taking care of dogs and all this stuff. Anyway, I have a song for you. I haven't played in a long, long time. Totally unpracticed. Morning Side of the Mountain. Talked long enough. Do a Simon Garfunkel a little later. Okay, hopefully this thing won't fall off. It's three pages across. There was a girl. There was a boy. If they had met, they might have found a world of joy. But he lived on the morning side of the mountain. On the twilight side of the hill. They never met, they never kissed, and they will never know what happiness they missed. For he lived on the morning side of the mountain, and she lived on the twilight side of the hill. Love's a rose that never grows without the kiss of the morning dew. For every Jack must have a Jill to know the thrill of a coming rose. And you and I are just like they. For all we know, our love is just a kiss away. For you are on the morning side of the mountain, and I am on the twilight side of the hill. There was a girl, there was a boy. I don't know who performed that. No clue.
It's lovely.
I think it was Kelly and Marie Osmond.
Yeah, I think it really was. No memory.
It was him.
Someone said Lisa Marie.
No, I think Donnie and Marie Osmond.
Donnie and Marie?
Oh.
Yeah. Mm. It's so far back.
Mm.
It's before memory in my time. Probably for a good reason.
All right. Before we go on to Mike Reeves, I'm going to welcome Donna Besser Stone, and I assume Gerald along with her.
No, probably not.
Possibly not. I don't know. It just says Donna Besser Stone on the thing, but I don't have the video up, so I can't tell if they're both there. They will be going last, of course. And that means after Doreen, who was after Anna and Ray, and it's Phil Mike Reeves.
And Donna says she's by herself tonight.
Gerald does this.
Yeah.
Okay, so she's by herself.
Okay. Yeah, he says, the world turned upside down. The words are taken from a broadsheet in about 1649, but the tune and melody, it was put to melody by Leon Russellson in about 1975. So, in 1649, to St. George's Hill, a ragged band they called the Diggers came to show the people's will. They defied the landlords, they defied the laws. They were the dispossessed, reclaiming what was theirs. We come in peace, they said, to dig and sow. We come to work the lands in common and to make the waste ground grow. This earth divided, we will make whole. So it will be a common treasury for all. The sin of property we do disdain. No man has any right to buy and sell the earth for private gain. By theft and murder, they took the land. Now everywhere the wars spring up at their command. They make the laws to chain us well. The clergy dazzle us with heaven, or they damn us into hell. We will not worship the god they serve, a god of greed who feed the rich while poor folks starve. We work and eat together, we need no swords. We will not bow to the masters or pay rent to the lords. Till we are free, though we are poor. Ye diggers all stand up for glory, stand up now. From the men of property the orders came. They sent the hired men and troopers to wipe out the diggers' claim. Tear down their cottages, destroy their corn. They were dispersed, but still the vision lingers on. Ye poor take courage, ye rich take care. This earth was made a common treasury for everyone to share. All things in common, all people one. We come in peace, the orders came to cut them down. We come in peace. The orders came to cut them down.
All right. Thank you, Mike. Bill Pardon.
Right. And this could be a big mistake so soon after coming back. About an hour ago, I was halfway through emailing Karen, who is back in New York now, and I'm glad to see they're back and settled. I'm assuming Debbie and Ron are back in New York as well now, because this will be reasonably relevant if they are. And if not, Anna and Ray, they are always relevant when you're talking about trains, aren't they? So I'm going to talk about trains. And halfway through doing this email, this song leapt into my head. Well, it's not a song. It was originally a poem by our lovely old English eccentric, now past, called Les Barker. And he actually wrote a poem saying that he's got so much love that the entire capacity of the New York subway system just wouldn't be enough to contain it all. So that was his way of about as near as Les Barker ever got to being romantic. But I'm taking a chance because I managed to dig out the lyrics in time. There was a tune, somebody recorded it to a tune which I can't remember who and I can't remember what. So it's going to get tuned on my whistle, which I haven't used for God knows how long as well. If you hear a few squeaks, it's just to replicate the sounds of the squeaky couplings and the dodgy hydraulics on the New York subway system. That's my excuse, he says. And it's called The Railways of New York. If this makes a horrible noise because my sound's not good, just wave and put your fingers in your ears or something, and then I'll stop using the whistle. I'll just carry on without it.
Beep.
All the trains on the subways that run through Manhattan can't carry the love that I carry for you. Though they run under Broadway and 7th forever, they'll never hold half of the love that I do. All the lines from New Jersey that lead to Penn Station can't hold all the feelings that my heart contains. As I understand it, the New Jersey Transit, however they planned it, just don't have the trains. And by the same token, the path from Hoboken to 33rd Street can't compete with this heart. All Grand Central Station can't hold my elation since your declaration that we'll never part. The love I've been saving's more than the New Haven could ship up the sound to the next state along. The Long Island Railroad could not tote this payload, but that's quite okay. No disgrace, nothing wrong. All the trains on the subways that run through Manhattan can't carry the love that I carry for you. Though they run under Broadway and 7th forever, they'll never hold half of the love that I do. Though they run under Broadway and 7th forever, they'll never hold half of the love that I do.
That's it. Very good. Though.
I just don't know what to say about that last whistle. Didn't sound like a railroad train.
It was all right, except the very high notes, wasn't it? The very top note was a bit squeaky.
Kathleen. Got something for
very
us?
Good, very good. I didn't know you played the whistle, Bill. Right, this is Kate Wolf. I'm working with, I've got two Kate Wolf songbooks, and I haven't even got through the first one yet. So, this is Leggett Serenade by Kate Wolf.
Chopping wood in the rain, the axe swings up and falls again. I watch you move so smoothly in the dance, listening to the hollow sounds, the spitting logs as they hit the ground. I'd build a fire for you if I had the chance. Let the chips fall where they can. I've tried my best to understand why we stand out here in the rain, in our anger and our pain, afraid to feel the love that's in our hands. So strong, stopped you short when it came along. Sometimes I wonder why you ever stay. 'Cause when you turn away and save yourself for a rainy day, love grows weak and then it starts to fade. Let the chips fall where they can. I tried my best to understand
you stand out here in the rain, in our anger and our pain, afraid to feel the love that's in our hands. In the winters wet and cold, some people change, some just grow old. The years go by, inspired for what you do. I'd like to lay you down and turn your twisted head around. But babe, there's really nothing I can do. Let the chips fall where they can. Tried my best to understand why we stand out here in the rain, in our anger and our pain, afraid to feel the love that's in our hands. Let the chips fall where they can. I tried my best to understand why we stand out here in the rain, in our anger and our pain, afraid to feel the love that's in our hands.
Good job, Kathleen.
Thank you, Kathleen. It's very nice. Debbie and Ron, or Ron and Debbie.
Debbie.
We are here. All right, here. Okay. So we have not done any Joe Jang song in a long time. We're going to do one now. It says, all I want is a garden.
Body down below and sing a song of heaven.
Thank you.
All right, so Ron has one absolutely not like that. An old country song.
That's another purloined pearl, from what I understand. There's some controversy surrounding this.
This song.
It here on the sheet is credited to A.P. Carter, but it's also a guy named Joe Mathus and a couple other guys claim that they wrote it too, so I don't know. Maybe I'll claim it as my own if you like it enough. Dim lights, thick smoke, and a loud, loud music. It's the only kind of life you'll ever understand.
Dim lights,
thick
smoke,
and a loud, loud music.
Do you open the other view? The
they're still not going to see it, though.
Yeah. Well,
All right, that's a good point. We'll have to, because nobody ever sees
us
play.
Well, you know, I mean, it's not just you. Other people, you know, they don't realize what we're seeing. And it's all good, but it's nice to see players actually use their instruments. That's part of the fun.
Uh-oh, Debbie, I think we're busted.
I'm trying to see if we can get up here on the... All right. I'm getting everyone else, but anyway, you can raise this. You can raise the picture on here.
Yeah, but it's still not going to see the instruments.
Okay. Well,
in any case,
we'll have to get a ladder for you.
We'll work it out.
So I'm farther up. Okay, we'll figure it out. Thank you.
In any case, it is time to travel north to the swamps in Lonnie Robbie.
Okay, I actually forgot my position. Let me.
Oh, nice. That's pretty.
Well, it's black, that's for sure.
Yeah. Black is beautiful, baby.
Yes, you're right. And I like that statement because I was born and raised in West Africa, where everyone was black except me. A train song called The Leaving of Nancy. In comes the train, and the whole platform shakes. It stops with a shudder and a screaming of brakes. The parting has come and my weary soul aches. I'm leaving my Nancy, but you stand there so calmly, determinedly gay. And you talk of the weather and events of the day. But your eyes tell me all that your tongue doesn't say. Goodbye, my Nancy, oh. And come a little closer. Put your head upon my shoulder and let me hold you one more time before the whistle blows. My suitcase is lifted and stowed on the train, and a thousand regrets whirl around in my brain. And the ache in my heart is a black sea of pain. I'm leaving my Nancy, oh. And just stand there so calmly, so lovely to see. But the grip of your hand is an unspoken plea. You're not fooling yourself, and you're not fooling me. Goodbye, my Nancy, oh. And come a little closer. Lay your head upon my shoulder and let me hold you one more time before the whistle blows. But our time has run out and the whistle has blown. And here I must leave you standing alone. We had so little time, and now the time's gone. Goodbye, my Nancy, oh. And as the train starts gently to roll, and as I lean out for to wave and to call, I see your forced tears trickle and fall. goodbye, my Nancy, oh. And am a little closer. Lay your head upon my shoulder and let me hold you one more time before the whistle blows. And come a little closer. Lay your head upon my shoulder and let me hold you one last time before the whistle blows. And there you have it, The Leaving of Nancy.
Fabulous song, well done.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lonnie and company. Mr. Gelb.
Okay, well, good afternoon, everybody. Yeah, Susan's not with us today. She's kind of lounging at the moment, recovering from she doesn't know what, but just not 100%. Anyways, second time around, I'm going to sing you the newest song that I wrote, but this time around I'm going to do a song that I know mostly from Gordon Bach, Ed Trickett, and Ann Muir did this, but several other people have recorded it, and I'm going to do Waltzing with Bears. I don't think I've done it before here, and it's another one of those songs that we were talking about today. A couple of people think they own it, and the original idea evidently comes from Dr. Seuss, you know, Theodore Geisel, I don't know if that's how he pronounced his name, where one of his books, he kind of introduced this theme. And then a couple of people tried to write their own version of it, and one gentleman named Dale Markin wrote a number of verses and submitted it to see whether he could get a joint copyright or something. And they told him that it was enough different that he could get his own copyright. So I don't know exactly who owns it, but anyway, it's a fun song. And basically it's G, C, and D7, you know. So I'm not gonna tell you the whole chorus. A lot of you probably know it. He goes wah, 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 wah. Waltzing with bears, raggy bears, shaggy bears, baggy bears too. There's nothing on earth Uncle Walter won't do. So he can go waltzing, wah, 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 waltzing. He can go waltzing, waltzing with bears. Well, I went into his room in the middle of the night, and I tiptoed inside, turned on the light, but to my surprise, there was no one in sight. Oh, my Uncle Walter goes waltzing at night. He goes wah, 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 waltzing with bears. Raggy bears, shaggy bears, baggy bears too. There's nothing on earth Uncle Walter won't do. So he can go waltzing, wah, 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 waltzing. He can go waltzing. I gave Uncle Walter a new coat to wear. When he came home, it was covered with hair. And lately I've noticed several new tears. I'm sure Uncle Walter goes waltzing with bears. He goes wah, 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 waltzing with bears. Raggy bears, shaggy bears, baggy bears too. There's nothing on earth Uncle Walter won't do. We told Uncle Walter that he should be good and do all the things that we said he should. But I know he'd rather be out in the woods. I'm afraid we might lose Uncle
you stay, and we managed to keep him home for a day. But the bears all barged in, and they took him away. Now he's waltzing with pandas, he can't understand her. And the bears all demand at least one dance a day. If I cut out at all, we're still having a little trouble with internet here. Thanks.
Well, you did cut out for a moment, but it was brief. Bill.
Okay. I'm going to play a couple of songs there that I have played to the group yesterday. And this song I wrote, I write sometimes about topics. Sometimes I just hear a line that I like. And I was on another Zoom group on last Thursday. So I wrote this Friday. The lady who was over there who did the group, at one point in time, there was a fellow who was doing it from a different location. And he was lamenting the fact that he didn't have his microphone and his reverb and all the toys that he usually sings through. And she made this line and it just kind of grabbed me. And so I said, I got to use it, what have you. And she said, you've got a great voice. She said, you don't put makeup on the Mona Lisa. So anyway, the song is called Better Off Left That Way. I'll never try to remake you. You're already far beyond par. I'll just sit back and admire, 'cause you're perfect just the way you are. There's nothing that I'd do over. I don't know what I could improve. And the more I think about it, you're exactly what I choose. You don't put makeup on the Mona Lisa. You don't reshape the pyramids. You can't change the color of the Taj Mahal or recompose the sacred hymns. And you don't rewrite all the scripture or recreate a fine Monet. These are already masterpieces, and they're better off left that way. We all have imperfections, tiny bit of what we correct. The area that we could work on to get a little more adept. But you tinker as you will and put everything in play. The end result is often things are better off left that way. I'll never try to remake you. You're already well beyond par. So I'll just sit back and admire. You're perfect just the way you are. See, there's nothing that I'd do over. I don't know what I could improve. And the more I think about it, you're exactly what I choose. You don't put makeup on the Mona Lisa. You don't reshape the pyramids. Can't change the color of the Taj Mahal or recompose the sacred hymns. You don't rewrite all the scripture or recreate a fine Monet. These are already masterpieces, and they're better off left that way. Better off left that way. Better off left that way.
Great words.
Good words, Bill.
Yeah, good song.
Bill. Great song, Bill.
Thank you.
Bill, you don't mess around with Jim either.
What's that?
You don't mess around with Jim either.
I forgot that. I'll put that in. It's another verse.
I have nothing to say to that. Hey, welcome back to the group, and let's
it's good to be back. Sorry we've been away for so long. We've been a little bit busy. Right. This is a song, it's called The Lifeboats. I think we've probably done it before. It was written by Ray's cousin, whose name is David Edgington, and it tells a true story of a shipwreck back in the days when if your ship got wrecked and anybody came out to rescue you, they came in a rowing boat, which takes a certain amount of courage and a large helping, I think, of being slightly off your rocker. Anyway, this is called The Lifeboats. It has a chorus if anyone wants to sing along. We row, we row, we row, we row. Except after the second verse when it changes to they rowed, and so on. And it goes like this.
Lifeboat men went to their watery graves.
Something called a calendar harmonium. It's basically a variation of an Indian harmonium. So you've got a keyboard there.
Yeah.
And bellows here.
Okay.
And so if you pump the bellows and don't press any notes, nothing happens. But once you press, then you can get notes out of it. It's just a mini version of that, really.
Okay. You played very nicely. It sounded great.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I wish we could have heard Bill's harmonica.
I did. I heard it.
Yes. But sadly, the rest of us didn't. Such is Zoom. We're going to do another song by David, actually. And this one is, it's about ancient ruins and that feeling that you sometimes get of being transported when you're walking through ancient ruins. And of course, this country has a lot of ancient ruins, but you know, America has them too. Anyone who's been to the cliff dwellings at Keetseal or Batatican has no doubt felt the same sort of magic. This is called Castle, anyway.
Just Christmas of years came rolling by, and I can see reality is just a state of mind. And as the evening starts to fall, walk the towers, touch the walls to understand the power of the past. Footprints on an unused track, turn the key and don't look back. The fading light begins to hide the place where I have been.
Lean on, lean on me. Lean on, lean on me.
As the castle rolls its shutters down, misty shroud lies all around.
Lean on, lean on me.
As the castle rolls its shutters down, a misty shroud lies all around.
Lean on, lean on me. Lean on.
Beautiful as always. All right, Doreen, it's your turn, but I don't think we have video for you, even though it indicates your video is turned on. Doreen.
She's got to unmute.
You have to unmute.
We have to mute.
Doreen has to unmute. Doreen doesn't unmute.
Doreen, yeah, she can't get her camera to work, but she's, I was trying to tell her what to do, but she said she can just sing without the video.
She's unmuted.
Yes, and I've unmuted her. She can do that now.
Okay. Oh, hi. Okay. Louder, Doreen.
Turn your volume. I gave you the power to unmute when I made the event. Oh, she's connecting to audio now. Okay.
She just said now she can't get audio either. If you can hear us, Doreen, you should go out and then come back in to the session. She said, all right. She doesn't think she can do it today. She sent me a chat.
Now what you should do is everybody give me their phone number. So if there's a problem, I can contact you by phone and talk you into getting the picture.
Well, right now my screen is showing her as having video, although I don't think that actually works, but she has no audio. So we're going to go on to the next person on the list, Donna Stone. Assuming Donna is going to perform to us today.
You're not going to perform. You're muted, so.
Donna?
She's shaking her head no, Delta. Yeah. By the way, Donna, I like your hairstyle, your new hairstyle. Looks good.
Can't hear you, Donna.
Hey, Donna, are you gonna perform? I've unmuted you. And if you
I can't see me. I can't see, you know, I can only see
I can see you and I can hear you.
I can only see seven of you. Part of my screen is out. And you know, I usually only perform with Gerald, although I have to admit that yesterday we did a song together and I didn't play, I just sang. But, you know, I'm having a good time, and I hope it's okay if I just...
That's okay. We just have to know so we can go on.
Yeah, appreciate it. Thank you so much. You're very sweet to give me an opportunity. And so okay. I won't oppress you with my sound.
Saul, are you going to sing for us?
Yeah, I have to fulfill a promise because I promised Kathleen I would
do a song today for her. So, you know, I just got back from the hospital and everything. It was a very interesting morning. I get up in the morning and it's, I look at my blood pressure, it's 200. I know what I have to call the Hatzalah, you know, the Jewish volunteer ambulance corps. They were here in 5 minutes. First I called Harvey. I was still in my pajamas. He was in his undershirt. I said, Harvey, I'm transferring the host ship to you. I don't know when I'll be back. They may keep me overnight. So anyway, they released me at 11:30. They released me. And the pressure is down to 160 now. Tomorrow I got to see the cardiologist. So that's the health report.
You are wrong about me being in my undershirt, however. I was not. That was just me you were looking at.
You didn't have that on either. Okay. Okay. I once did the song before, and Kathleen loved it, and she asked if we could do it again. Okay, the song was written by a man by the name of A.B. Rottenberg, who was largely unknown, except he's in the Orthodox Jewish community. And the song that he wrote, this song was probably not heard of outside either until a friend of mine, who happens to be an Orthodox Jew, but is also a bluegrass singer by the name of Jerry Wisentowski. He asked Amy, can I record the song? And he recorded it together with Tim O'Brien, who's one of the best sound men today in bluegrass. And it's about two twins who are in the womb and are about to be born. You know, they've been there for 9 months and they talk to each other, maybe with telepathy, whatever it is. And one of them is an optimist and one is a pessimist. And they're wondering, you know, what's this existence? Is there something in the future, you know? Normally this is sung by two people. When Amy first recorded, he did it with his son. And when Jerry Wisentowski recorded it, he did it with Tim O'Brien. So I'm gonna have to do two parts. And when I sing the first part, I'll put up one finger, which means that's the first person. Next one is the other brother who's answering him. I'll put up two fingers so you'll know which part is which. I have to sing both parts. It's called Conversation in the Womb. The first one is the pessimist. The second one is the optimist. My dear brother, look around you and tell me what your eyes behold. Don't deny it at your sea. It's only you and me. Our existence, it is empty, it is cold. Our existence, it is empty, it is cold. But dear brother, you must have faith that we are not the only ones. Cause in the distance there's a place we will stand up tall and straight. Oh, I believe that there is a world to come. Yes, I believe there is a world to come. My dear brother, don't be blind, don't be stubborn, don't be sad. Imagination, it's all right, but it won't light up the night. What you see is exactly what you get. What you see is exactly what you get. But dear brother, you will surely find when all is said and done that the future, it will show there is so much we don't know. Oh, I believe that there is a world to come. Yes, I believe that there is a world to come. My dear brother, where have you gone? Is this the moment I have known? I can faintly hear the cry. My dear brother must have died. It's all over now, forever I'm alone. It's all over now, forever I'm alone. But dear brother, don't warn me when my life has just begun. What you hear are sounds of joy. Congratulations, it's a boy. Oh, I believe that there is a world to come. Yes, I believe that there is a world to come. 'cause what you hear are sounds of joy. Congratulations, it's a boy. Soon you'll be here with me in this world to come. Soon you'll be with me here in this world to come. Amy Rottenberg.
It's lovely.
I like that. Good choice, Kathy.
Both our versions are available on YouTube. If anyone wants, I send Kathleen links. I'll send the links. One is the traditional version that the author wrote. The other one is Jerry Wisentowski's bluegrass version of the same song.
Yeah, they're great. Both very different, but they're both great.
All right, now you guys have been kindly serenading me so far today, and now you have to pay the price. You have to listen to me. Because it's the last song in the first round. I'm going to do a Gordon Lightfoot song called Ribbon of Darkness. And unfortunately, it's going to start out with me attempting to whistle, which sometimes works and sometimes my whistle is broken. Darkness over me, since my true love walked out the door. Words I never heard before. Darkness over me, clouds gathering on my head. Kill the day and hide the sun. That shroud the night when day is done. The ribbon of darkness holds. It is falling on the man. Where once my love and I did lie. And now she's gone from me. My love, goodbye. Ribbon of darkness over me. Once the world was young as spring, where flowers did bloom and birds did sing. Ribbon of darkness over me. It's cold moonlight. Don't want to see no one but you. But I wish I could be dying to forget you. Your heart could see how mine just aches and breaks all day. Come on home and take away this ribbon of darkness. Oh, yes, come on home and take away this ribbon of darkness. Oh, now we've come around and Swambo gets to do one. Move the mic in front of your mouth.
Small detail.
Small detail. Yeah, talking in the mic.
Okay.
Javi, on the low notes, you are inaudible on the low notes.
I'll need to buy a different microphone. We'll put a capo on.
Okay. All right. My second song here is Morning Has Broken. And it was arranged by Cat Stevens.
Actually, words written by an English author, Eleanor Fargen, inspired by the village of Alfriston in East Sussex, and set to a traditional Scottish Gaelic tune called Bunisson. You're not going to get to hear Rick Wakeman on the piano, though.
Morning has broken like the first morning. Blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Praise for the singing, praise for the morning, praise for the springing, fresh from sweet the rains do fall, sunlit from heaven, like the first dew fall on the first grass. Praise for the sweetness of the wet garden, spring in completeness where his feet pass. Mine is the sunlight. Mine is the morning, born of the one light, evening's our play. Rings with elation, raise every morning, God's recreation of the new day. Morning has broken like the first morning. Blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Praise for the singing, praise for the morning, praise for them springing fresh from the world.
Harvey, do you have your original sound on?
Yes. Oh, I did.
Yeah, I'm getting a lot of, again, I don't know if it's my internet connection or not, but it went in and out, in and out.
It got turned off somehow. Mm. And I don't know how. I had it on before, and then suddenly it was off just now.
Thanks for catching that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I'm glad to hear that because I didn't know whether it was me or what.
It's the ghost in the machine.
Evidently, my computer has decided to change settings on me without me actually touching any buttons. I always appreciate it when it does things like that for me.
Are you going to be able to change it?
Okay, so now it's Murray's shot.
Okay. Okay. The last song I sang, which was by Bob Dylan, a lot of people, you know, kind of were suspicious about it, that it's irreligious because he said, you know, he was ridiculing God on our side. But actually, he is a religious person. He just gave an interview recently where he said not only does he read the Old Testament scriptures, he also reads the New Testament and the Pauline epistles and all that, and that he is a Christian, that you know, because a lot of people also were wondering about that, whether he became a Christian or he decided at one point to be a Christian and then changed back to Jew, but actually he is a confirmed Christian as far as he's concerned. However, the song that I'm now going to sing is by John Lennon, and he is an irreligious and atheist person. And he really does want to get rid of religion altogether. And the song that he's singing and became very popular is Imagine. And he wrote this in 1971 and recorded it then. Okay. Imagine there's no heaven. It's easy if you try. No hell below us, above us only sky. Imagine all the people living for today. Oh, oops, I'm a little high. Let me go down. Imagine there's no heaven. It's easy if you try. No hell below us, above us only sky. Imagine all the people living for today. Oh, imagine there's no countries. It isn't hard to do. Nothing to kill or die for, and no religion too. Imagine all the people living life in peace. Oh, you may say that I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us and the world will be as one. Imagine no possessions. I wonder if you can. No need for greed or hunger, a brotherhood of man. Imagine all the people sharing all the world. Oh, you may say that I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us and the world will live as one. That's it.
Excellent.
All right, Stephen.
This song is by Fred Small. I don't know how many of you know of him. He's a minister now, but he was once a folk singer. Van Merle was a mighty friendly man. He's big and round like a bear. He hugs his friends and his friends hug him anytime, anywhere. His patients would come for therapy to drive their blues away. And sooner or later they'd feel a lot better, cause this is what he'd say. I want to hug when we say hello. I want to hug when it's time to go. I want to hug because I want you to know I'm awfully fond of you. I want to hug. What a wonderful feeling. Want to hug to feel you squeezing. Want to hug because it certainly seems like the natural thing to do. When the head of the hospital heard about it, he got all annoyed, because hugging is sexual sublimation, according to Dr. Freud. You can beat him down, you can lock him away, you can keep him quiet with drugs, you can strap him and zap him with electric shock, but you better not give him a hug. I want a hug when we say hello. I want a hug when it's time to go. I want a hug because I want you to know I'm awfully fond of you. I want a hug. What a wonderful feeling. Want a hug to feel you squeezing. Want a hug because it certainly seems like the natural thing to do. Well, the boss says, Dan, clean out your desk. Your conduct is black and blue. Any deviation from standard medical practice can get us sued. But Dan don't feel too bad for himself. He's really kind of proud. But he's sorry for people who are locked away when we're hugging ain't allowed. I want to hug when you say hello. I want to hug when it's time to go. I want to hug because I want you to know I'm awfully fond of you. I want to hug. What a wonderful feeling. I want to hug to feel you squeezing. I want to hug because it certainly seems like a natural thing to do.
Okay, thank you, Steve. Mr. Winkler.
Okay, I'm gonna.
I'm already asking you. Okay, he knows.
Okay, well, I managed to make an offer on a house in the last hour between the last song I did and this one. So, I'm buying a house. Anyway, I thought I'd do it. Having said that, gonna do a Paul Simon song. Getting things done. Softly creeping, left its seed while I was sleeping, and the vision that was planted in my brain still remains within the sound of silence. Cobblestone, neath the halo of an old street lamp, turn my collar to the cold and damp, and my eyes are stabbed by the flash of the neon light. Spent the night, touch the sound. Again, because
the vision softly creeping, left a seed while I was sleeping, and the vision that was planted in my brain still remains within the sound of silence.
Yeah, Bob. Where in Arizona are you moving to, Bob?
You're muted.
We can't hear the answer.
Says the closing is going to be on July 3rd. Always try to move on a hot day.
Where? We didn't hear. You were muted then.
Looks like right now. We have a closing for July 3rd.
What city?
Chandler, Arizona, okay. Which is the most southern part of the Phoenix area. Always, all my life, I've either moved on the coldest day of the year or the hottest day of the year. And July 3rd should be a darn hot day. We have the closing on this house. If everything goes to plan, will be June 30th, and the new house will be July 3rd. So we'll be in a tent for 3 days.
Be cool in Flagstaff.
Could be fun.
Okay, that'd be a very intense situation.
Of course.
Mr. Reeves.
Right, yes, it's me. It's Wild Colonial Boy. This has got referred to back in 1880. So there was a Wild Colonial Boy, Jack Duggan was his name. He was born and reared in Ireland in a place called Castlemaine. He was his father's only son, his mother's pride and joy. And dearly did his parents love the Wild Colonial Boy. At the early age of 16 years, he left his native home, and to Australia's sunny shores he was inclined to roam. He robbed the rich, he helped the poor, he shot James McAvoy, a terror to Australia was the Wild Colonial Boy. We'll roam the mountains and the glen, we'll ride across the plains. We scorn to live in slavery, bound down by iron chains. One morning on the prairie, as Jackie rode along, while listening to the mockingbird singing the cheerful song, a jumped up band of troopers, Kelly Davis and Fitzroy. They all set out to capture him, the Wild Colonial Boy. Surrender now, Jack Duggan, for you see we're 3-1. Surrender in the King's high name, you are a plundering son. Jack drew two pistols from his belt and proudly waved them high. I'll fight but not surrender, cried the Wild Colonial Boy. We'll roam the mountains and the glens, we'll ride across the plains. We scorn to live in slavery, bound down by iron chains. He fired a shot at Kelly, which brought him to the ground. He fired point blank at Davis, who fell dead at the sound. A bullet pierced his proud young heart from the pistol of Fitzroy, and that was how they captured him, the Wild Colonial Boy. We'll roam the mountains and the glens, we'll ride across the plains. We scorn to live in slavery, bound down by iron chains. Wild Colonial Boy.
And now to see what the continuing collection of hats he can wear is Bill Pardon.
But I'm hatless. I forgot to think about that. But I'm going to keep the Irish connection going then in this case. And, when I was just a little bit, only a few minutes ago, actually, when I was looking for the Railways of New York song, I stumbled across another Les Barker classic, which I used to sing regularly. I can't remember when I stopped singing it, but I just hadn't sung it for so long. Can't remember the words or anything, but it refers to, among other things, one of the, still are, one of the biggest selling girl bands. And there was an Irish family with an endless supply of daughters, and the family were the Nolans. The Nolan sisters were quite famous. They were very famous in this country. All us English people will know of the Nolans. Does anybody in America ever remember hearing an Irish girl band called the Nolans? It's all going to be worse. Oh, Lonnie's got it. Yeah, well done, Lonnie. So, yeah, they were very big in their time anyway. And that's just a bit of background to see if I can find what key I need to sing this one in. I think if I pitch it in C, I might get some of the high notes and some of the low notes, but I might not. But anyway, yes, this is another Les Barker parody, and it's called Nolans. My favourite albums I can't find. Nolan's, Nolan's and Elton John. They've disappeared, I fear some swine's stolen my Nolan's away. I dreamed a dream the other night. Nolan's, Nolan's and Elton John. And it was true, someone has quite stolen my Nolan's away. And they were all on vinyl too. Nolan's, Nolan's and Elton John. Who done the deed, I wonder who? Stolen my Nolans away. I doubt if they could be replaced. Nolans, Nolans and Elton John. Some person of exquisite taste. Stolen my Nolans away. Them album sleeves was my delight. Nolans, Nolans and Elton John. The swine who stole away Reg Dwight. Stolen my Nolans away. I'll have to go and buy CDs. Nolans, Nolans and Elton John. Some lover of fine harmonies. Stolen my Nolans away. I dreamed a dream the other night. Nolans, Nolans and Elton John. And it was true, someone has quite stolen my Nolans away.
That's about it. Lost several albums in my day. Yeah.
Oh, God, Les Barker, what a bloody legend.
Mad.
I fear I might have one I could lend you.
What about Matt Monroe, Bill? I mean,
yes, I know Matt Monroe. Used to be a bus driver, you know, and then he learned to sing, and he was famous, and now he's well gone. Yeah. I think. There we go.
All right, Kathleen, can we hear from you now?
Yes. I just first of all, I want to say thank you very much, Sol, for singing that song for me.
My pleasure.
And, hope you're all right. Hope you're better. And I'm sure there's a Nolan CD in our box up at the Hoy. We've got a box of CDs, haven't we, for sale, about £1 each. I'm sure there's one in there. Okay. Right, I'm going to sing a song that I heard first by Anne Mayo Muir and Gordon and Ed, but it's written by David Mallett, and it's called I Knew This Place. And I thought I've done this one before, but it reminded me, because when I did the other song today about chopping wood, it reminded me of my granddad, that he was very short-sighted. You could hardly see in the end, and he used to chop wood out in the garden with a chopper thing, axe. And it used to worry me that he was going to chop his finger off or something, because he would put his finger in the place where he wanted to put it to chop, and chop right by his finger. But he never did chop his finger off, I'm glad to say. But it just reminded me of that. And then I thought of this song, that this reminds me of my brother, because it says my brother's laugh in it. So two sort of looking back songs. So this is I Knew This Place. It's getting dark in here, so I'm hoping I can see what's happening. And I've got old glasses on because I broke my glasses. I knew this place, I knew it well. Every sound and every smell. And every time I walked, I fell for the first 2 years or so. There across the grassy yard, I a young one running hard. Brown and bruised and battle-scarred and lost in sweet illusion. From my window I can see the fingers of an ancient tree. Reaching out it calls to me to climb its sunny branches. But all my climbing days are gone, these tired legs I'm standing on. But scarcely dare to leave the spot upon which they are standing. And I remember every word of every voice I've ever heard. Every frog and every bird, this is where it starts. My brother's laugh, the sighing wind, this is where my life begins. This is where I learned to use my hands and hear my heart. This house is old, it carries on, like verses in an old-time song. Always changed but never gone, this house can stand the seasons. Our lives pass on from door to door, dust across a wooden floor. Feather rain and thunder roar, we need not know the reason. And as these thoughts come back to me, like ships across a friendly sea, like breezes blowing endlessly, like rivers running deep. The day is done, the lights are low, the wheels of life are turned slow. And as these visions turn and go, I lay me down to sleep. I knew this place, I knew it well. Every sound and every cell. Every time I walked, I fell. The first 2 years or so. The day is done, the lights are low, the wheels of life are turning slow. And as these visions turn and go, I lay me down to sleep.
Thank you, Kathleen. Debbie and Ron.
Okay.
Okay, here's a song by Utah Phillips, and I'm going to play it on the same instrument I've played other tunes on today.
Yes, which you still can't see, I guess, but...
I still can't see it. Is that the moon I see?
you. Thank you, guys. All right. So we will close with a gospel, or actually, this is an African American spiritual.
Yeah, it's just to avoid controversy. We're not going to play any instruments at all.
My Lord, what a morning.
My Lord, what a morning.
My Lord, what a morning.
When the stars begin to fall,
you will weep for the rocks and mountains.
You will weep for the rocks and mountains.
You will weep for the rocks and mountains.
When the stars begin to fall,
you will hear the trumpet sound
to wake the nations underground. You will hear the trumpet sounding when the stars begin to fall.
My Lord, what a morning.
My Lord, what a stars begin to fall.
Oh, sinners, what will you do?
Oh, sinners, what will you do?
Oh, sinners, what will you do?
When the stars begin to fall,
you will shout and pray for victory.
You will shout and pray for victory.
You will shout and pray for victory.
When the stars begin to fall.
My Lord, what a morning.
My Lord, what a morning. My Lord, what a morning. When the stars begin to fall.
Nice job.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Doreen. Third part.
Very nice.
Very nice.
Thank you.
Lonnie.
Yes. I want to do a song by a fellow who pretty much the same age I am, and I think he left from a place in Scotland called Glasgow, and he moved down to London, where instead of pursuing a purely folk path, he fell in with people like John Renborn and Bert Jansch and those guys who were more like jazz musicians, and he did this song, which I happen to like.
What do you have?
Dear wind that shakes the barley free, blow home my true love ship to me, fill her sails, high a weary weight upon the shore. forsake her not in times of storm. Protect her oaken beams from harm, fill her sails. I, a weary, wait upon the shore. Whether he be in Africa or deep asleep in India, fill his dreams. I, a weary, wait upon the shore. Yes, snow white gulls upon the wing, I, like you, am lamenting for my love. I, a weary, wait upon the shore. And in my chariot of sleep, I ride the vast and dreamy deep, deep sea. I awake a weary on the shore. For 7 years and 7 days, no man has seen my woman ways, dear God. I, a weary, cry upon the shore. Along the shingle beach I go, the wind about me as I make my way to my weary dream upon my bed. Dear wind that shakes the barley free, blow on my true love's ship to me, fill her sails. I, a weary, wait upon the shore. I, a weary, wait upon the shore.
Mr. Leach.
All right, Bob.
Yes, and again, I apologize if I go in and out a little bit. I don't know, last week just started the internet problem. I don't know what's going on, but anyway. Anyways, there's several other songwriters on our Zoom here today, and I just call it, I have an active mind. Thoughts go through all the time, and sometimes it causes me to lose sleep and whatnot. It's so I guess it's a blessing and a curse all at the same time. Anyway, this is the latest song that I've written, and it's nothing like any other song that I've wrote. And I said to Susan, because some of this came, you know, in I don't know where from, early in the morning, and I just started writing it down. And I said to Susan, did I write a children's song? She said, no, I think you wrote a happy song. So, and I looked at it this morning and I said, you know, to myself, maybe it has a little something to do with aging too. Anyway, it goes like this. Stay while you walk along your way. May the little birdie sing and the sun shine down on everything. May it rain occasionally on the flowers, grass, plants and trees. May you never lose your way. Always have a very nice day. I saw an old man sitting in his chair. He wasn't going anywhere. I asked him why he sits all day. He says he's already been that way. And I saw an old woman who was walking slow. I asked her why her feet won't go. She said she used to jump and dance, but her bones don't get a second chance. So have a very nice day while you walk along your way. May the little birdie sing and the sun shine down on everything. May it rain occasionally on the flowers, grass, plants, and trees. May you never lose your way and always have a very nice day. And I saw a young lady, she was in her prime, going up the stairs two at a time. She was going home to her children three. They'll all grow up if you wait and see. And I met a girl, she skipped along. She wore a blue dress, singing a song. Said to her, that's a very nice tune. She said she learned it in the month of June. So have a very nice day while you walk along your way. May the little birdie sing and the sun shine down on everything. May it rain occasionally on the flowers, grass, plants, and trees. And may you never lose your way and always have a very nice day. I met a young boy, he's skipping stones over to the water to places unknown. He wanted to know if I had the time. I said I had, but it wasn't mine. So have a very nice day while you walk along your way. And may the little birdie sing and the sun shine down on everything. May it rain occasionally on the flowers, grass, plants, and trees. May you never lose your way and always have a very nice day. That's it.
Little ditty. Very nice day now.
Very good. Very nice.
Bob.
It's lovely.
It's a good one, Bob.
Very nice song. Mr. Bill.
Okay. I was playing along with you, by the way, Bob. I like that a lot, and I identify with waking up in the middle of the night with words. This one's called A Thousand Photographs. Yeah, those are my old bell bottoms and my purple leisure suit. And here you're in that mini dress. I think you're awful cute. My hair is to my shoulders. I just shake my head and laugh. A glass of wine, a little time, a thousand photographs. That's me with the whole band. We played real music back then. And there's your crazy cousin and your weird old Uncle Ken. You can't see the VW bus. You know we parked it in the back. A glass of wine, a little time, a thousand photographs. My brother was a soldier. Thank God they kept him out of harm. They sent him off to Europe while his friends got Vietnam. And here we're at a protest when they took away the draft. A glass of wine, a little time, a thousand photographs. Look, this one's at our wedding. All the presents people sent. It seems like only yesterday. I'm not sure where the time went. I guess our lives just happened. Not too much was choreographed. A
glass of wine, a little time, a thousand photographs. We've chronicled our history when we weren't feeling all this rust. To others it won't matter, but it matters lots to us. We've kept these memories all these years. I guess we're just two old pack rats. A glass of wine, a little time, a thousand photographs. My brother was a soldier. Thank God they kept him out of harm. They sent him off to Europe while his friends got Vietnam. And here we're at a protest when they took away the draft. You know, a glass of wine, a little time, a thousand photographs. A glass of wine, a little time, a thousand photographs. A glass of wine, a little time, a thousand photographs.
Good, Bill. I can relate. Went to Germany, year and a half. Yeah.
That's a really good song.
Thank you.
Thank you, Anna and Ray.
Okay. We're going to do a song by Corinne Polwart, who is a Scottish singer-songwriter. And the song is about St. Paul's Cathedral. And you see sort of three moments in history when St. Paul's Cathedral has been very significant as a symbol. And the first was when it was built, because it was built after the Great Fire of London as a sort of symbol of hope. And the second is during the Blitz, when there was a very famous photograph of it silhouetted against a wall of fire as London was bombed. And the third verse is about the Occupy movement, which was a protest against all sorts of things, but basically the amount of power the wealthy people have and how they were abusing that. And that was not too long ago, and I think we could probably use that again if anybody wants to to kickstart the Occupy movement again. The song is called King of Birds, which is a pun on the name of Christopher Wren, because in English folklore the wren is the king of birds. It's got a woe along chorus if you'd like to woe along with us. Here we go.
At Ludgate Hill, on the cracked and blackened cobbles of the town, the ashes fall to rest as the tiny king of birds he flutters down. To build a citadel, to light glory in the dark, and from hell to breathe hope in every heart. Whoa.
Oh,
Clouds of smoke and mirrors bruise the sky. The pilgrims huddle in as the tiny king of birds begins to cry. The people start to sing to light glory in the dark, to ring the bell and to breathe hope in every heart. Whoa.
Clever song, isn't it? I think we've done this one here before as well. One of our favourite webcams to watch is the Nautilus Live Marine Exploration Vessel. And I'm pleased to report that they are actually on a cruise right now. And we've been watching them and their deep sea diving robots. Which are very exciting, feeding a video link back to not only the people on deck, but also to the webcam, so we can watch the discoveries as they happen. It's really good fun. And this is a song called Blue Water. Now, Blue Water, when they're exploring in the depths, it takes the robots a couple of hours to actually swim down from the surface to the bottom of the sea. And they call that the Blue Water time. That's when there's nothing really much to see and they have to chat among themselves. So this is a song to keep them entertained during that. It's called Blue Water. There's a chorus. Sing along.
It's a long way down to the bottom of the ocean. It's a long way down to the bottom of the sea.
That's your bit.
Far beneath the sunlit world, where salty waves are breaking. Far below the crystal blue, where gannets dive so free. They seek the deep and silent zone, the dark illuminating, bringing it to light for all to see.
It's a long way down to the bottom of the ocean. It's a long way down to the bottom of the sea. It's a long way down to the bottom of the ocean. It's a long way down to the bottom of the sea.
Cannot venture on into the darkness with its mysteries unseen.
Comes a modern Hercules to photograph and measure,
like a real life yellow submarine.
To lie way down to the bottom of the ocean. It's a long way down to the bottom of the sea. It's a long way down to the bottom of the ocean. It's a long way down to the bottom of the sea.
And up on deck, the scientists are watching through the tether.
Connected by technology which weaves us all together.
Experiences shared by you and
It's a long way down to the bottom of the ocean. It's a long way down to the bottom of the sea. It's a long way down to the bottom of the ocean. It's a long way down to the bottom of the sea. It's a long way down to the bottom of the ocean. It's a long way down to the bottom of the sea. It's a long way down to the bottom of the ocean. It's a long way down to the bottom of the sea.
Thank you, Anna and Ray. Doreen, last I checked, I could see you.
Yes, and you can hear me, I bet.
I can.
I fixed it. Yeah. So, Anna, she sang the first song that she heard by Corinne Polwart in Scotland, and I went to Carnegie Hall to hear her sing. And you probably all know this song, but I had never heard it before. It's called Crow on the Cradle. So I'm going to sing. Sheep's in the meadow, the cow's in the corn. Now is the time for our child to be born. He'll cry at the moon and he'll laugh at the sun. If he's a boy, then he'll carry a gun, cries the crow on the cradle. Well, here we go. And if it should be that our child is a girl, never you mind if her hair doesn't curl. Ring on her finger and bells on her toes, above her wherever she goes, cries the crow on the cradle. Rock-a-bye, baby, the black and the white. Somebody's baby is born for to fight. Rock-a-bye, baby, the white and the black. Somebody's baby is not coming back, cries the crow on the cradle. Your mama and papa, they scrimp and they say, build you a coffin and dig you a grave. Hush-a-bye, little one, why do you weep? We have a toy that will put you to sleep, cries the crow on the cradle. We have a gun that will shoot that bird dead. That's what your mama and papa once said. Crow on the cradle, now what shall I do? That is the thing that I leave up to you, cries the crow. Crow.
On the cradle. That's it. Very nicely done. Yeah.
Now, Doreen, since you had equipment failure problems for your first round, would you like to do your second song now?
Okay. Well, I was humming this in the car today, and my husband had never heard it. It's Joni Mitchell's Little Green. I guess when she was back in Canada, right? she got pregnant. She was married to somebody Mitchell. Anyway, and then he left and she couldn't afford to keep the baby, I guess, and put it up for adoption. So, and she called the little girl Little Green. So here we go. Born with the moon in Cancer. Choose her a name she will answer to. Call her green and the winters cannot fade her. Call her green for the children who've made her little green. Be a gypsy dancer. He went to California, hearing that everything's warmer. So you write him a letter and say, her eyes are blue. He sends you a poem and she's lost to you. He's a nonconformer, just a little green, like the color when the spring is born. There'll be crocuses to bring to school tomorrow, just a little green, like the nights when the northern lights perform. There'll be icicles and birthday clothes, and sometimes there'll be sorrow. Child with a child's pretending, weary of lies you've been sending home. So you sign all the papers in the family name. You're sad and you're sorry, but you're not ashamed. Have a happy ending. Just a little green, like the color when the spring is born. There'll be crocuses to bring to school tomorrow. Just a little green, like the nights when the northern lights perform. There'll be icicles and birthday clothes, and sometimes there'll be sorrow. That's it. Thank you.
Really lovely.
Participate, you don't get the part. All right, Saul, you doing a second one?
I think I will. Usually I'm in, I prepared the lyrics. I did the first one I prepared during the week because I knew I had promised Kathleen I was going to do it. So, but last night I didn't feel what I, and I said I'm going to prepare the lyrics in the morning. The morning I ended up in the emergency room in the hospital for a few years. I couldn't prepare it. So I'm going to take a song which I wrote. I hope I remember the words to it. And it's a parody actually. But I have to do a little explanation before that. All the people who have ever worry about politics, you think politics is wild, whether it's in Washington or in London or anywhere else, you've never been to a synagogue board meeting. And Murray knows exactly which synagogue I'm talking about. So anyway, I mean, this synagogue had was one we had just founded. It had some of the most misfits on the board that we've ever seen. I think the whole synagogue held around 40 people or so. Now, usually if you go into a synagogue, you know, no one asks you for money, you know, it's free. Except when you come on the high holidays, Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur, which is, you know, the New Year and the Day of Atonement. Because those days you find anybody who's ever been in the synagogue before, those are the days that come and they say, that's the time, you know, they have to come. That's the time we want to get them for the money. But really, you know, according to Jewish law, anybody who wants to come to a synagogue is supposed to be allowed in. So we got to this board meeting. Now, I have to explain, there are three terms that I have to explain. First of all, in Orthodox synagogue, they use the name shul, which is the old Yiddish word. It's being, we get in shul, around, we go to shul. Usually if it's synagogue, it's the Yiddish word for synagogue, but they usually refer to it as a shul, and it's actually made its way into the English language. Now you have a synagogue, the usually the conservative synagogue, you'll call it the synagogue. If it's a Reform synagogue, they'll call it a temple. And that's the old joke, you know, that Abraham Lincoln was the first Jewish president because he was shot in the temple. So now this song, I use the word shul because it's an Orthodox shul. So at this board meeting, you had people who were debating, what are you going to do for the high holidays? Actually, everybody said, okay, they were going to pay the dues included the seats for the high holidays. The dues for the in those days was library, it was $300. I mean, by comparison, what we pay here in Boca is $1,800. So I mean, for there it was cheap compared, but for people who didn't have it, the $300 meant the difference between putting food on the table, you know, or not going to the synagogue. So we had a few people there who were real wise guys. And the treasurer, he said, let these people know, if they, these two families, if they can't come in, let them walk some. I said, they can't walk because on the Jewish holiday, you're not allowed to ride. And the nearest Orthodox synagogue is 6 miles up the road, Willowbrook. You can't do that. So they say, though, they were going to do it anyhow. They were not going to let them in. And the treasurer of the synagogue, he was a guy who was a retired IRS agent, and he had no mercy at all. He says, we're going to go, and we're going to hire Pinkerton guards with billy clubs to keep these two families out. And that's exactly what they did. Where it would have been $600, no, to let the people in, you know, but they paid over $1,000 for Pinkerton guards to come in. So in fact, Faye and I were so angry that we went to her in-law. You know, I was supposed to, we'd be one of the cantors that day. I wasn't going to do it. We went to her parents in Brooklyn for the holidays. So I based this on the Clancy Brothers song, Welcome to Our House. And there are just two more things I have to explain. On the Day of Atonement, which is the holiest day of the year, it starts off with a prayer called Kol Nidre. It ushers in this, it's at night, it ushers in the holiest day, that prayer called Kol Nidre, on that for the high holidays. Then also during the day and a few other times during the year, people come in to say Yizkor. Yizkor is a memorial service for the, you know, for the departed. So people say, oh, we got to honor our parents. So when you don't see them any other day, you'll see them on Yizkor, they come in. And then the third stanza deals with the bar mitzvah. I think everybody knows what the bar mitzvah is, you know, it's a confirmation. A boy is 13 years old, for a girl it's 12 years old, okay? So this is the song that I wrote. A man came to our shul, to our shul, to our shul. A man came to our shul for Kol Nidre. But he didn't have a ticket, so we called the man from Pinkerton, who hit him with a billy club and sent him on his way. You're always welcome at our shul any high holiday. But we're always welcome at our shul if we know you will pay. A woman came to our shul, A woman came to our shul, Yizkor for to say. But she didn't have the dough, so we told her where to go. And it wasn't up to heaven, but the place below. You're always welcome at our shul. You're always welcome to pray. But you're only welcome at our shul if we know you will pay. A child came to our shul, to our shul, to our shul. A child came to our shul on bar mitzvah day. But his parents had no money, so which we didn't think was funny. And instead of being welcomed, he was turned away. You're always welcome at our shul. You're always welcome to pray. But you're only welcome at our shul if we know you can pay. and we know you will pay. Wrote that song because I was angry.
Well, now you know why I quit the last synagogue I was a member of.
Was Rabbi Singer still the rabbi at that time?
No, we had that was at the end, right before I moved, it was Rabbi Kaufman, who was, his father was a big rabbi in Montreal. It was his first job. He was still wet behind the ears, and he didn't want to antagonize the board of directors. That was the problem there.
All right, well, you lucky people, it is now my turn. Or maybe it's you unlucky people. So I'm going to close this out. This is a fairly short song. Actually written and performed by Ian Anderson as part of the Jethro Tull, and it's off the Aqualung album. It's called Wondering Aloud. Wondering aloud how we feel today. Last night's hip to sunset, my hands in the red. We are our own saviors as a star, both our hearts beating alive.
Short.
Yes, but the session has been long. And I thank you all for coming. And Saul's going to take over again next week.
God willing. I'm going to the cardiologist tomorrow, and hopefully everything should be okay. I just have to adjust the medication. That's what they told me.
Tell him we told you to tell him he better sort you out.
Thank you so much.
Tell the cardiologist that we said he has to fix it up.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. Good to see everybody.
And
Thanks, Toby. Take care.
Please thank Bobby for taking over at the last minute.
Yeah.
He saved the program for me. Otherwise, I had a real problem. Thank you again, Bobby.
Bye-bye, everybody. Have a good week.
Bye, y'all.
Good to see you all.
Bye.
See you next time.